know, Geoff, let's face it. Today there are many choices for arrows. You can go on Amazon and you can find arrows that are super cheap. What you're not getting is you're not getting weight consistency. If you are getting weight consistency, you're not getting spine consistency out of those arrows. If those were measured by the average consumer, they might be horrified by what they see. However, not everyone has access to a machine that can measure spine to super accuracy. And as a result, they don't see that aspect. And if they're a beginner, they might just put off the fact that the arrow's deviating left to right to their own form. And some of that might be true. But a percentage of it is certainly from the fact that each of those arrows may not be the same spine value, may not hit to the same spot, even if shot by a top professional. If you go back 75, 80, 90 years to when Doug Easton was developing aluminum arrows, his main motivator was to have consistent spine from shaft to shaft to shaft. Aluminum alloy is accurate to 3 decimal places in a factor called Young's modulus of elasticity. That is the weight to stiffness ratio of that material. It means that for a given weight, the stiffness is always going to be dead on for an aluminum arrow if the tolerances are tight enough. And Easton runs its tolerances to 50 millionths of an inch. No one in the industry has tighter tolerances. One of the things that we have always offered consumers is confidence. Confidence that every arrow in that dozen hits those specifications. Confidence that every arrow we send out of this building is going to have our guarantee that you're going to get what you're paying for. You're going to get those tolerances. That is one of the things that makes Easton stand apart for more than 100 years.
Yeah, and when you buy that Easton arrow your first year starting out with archery, in year one, down the road to year 5, if you purchase that next dozen of arrows, we can assure you it's going to be the exact same quality, that it's going to be the exact same stiffness in that spine.
That means that the Easton Aluminum X7 that you buy today has the exact same spine as your grandfather's X7s from 1964.
That's a great point, yeah.
And it's an important consideration when we look at things like our AC arrows, where the core is made of that same high-precision, high-strength Easton Aluminum. That provides for a superior backbone for the spine value to be as perfect as it can be with industrial processing.
Yeah, and again, that talks about the quality coming out of the Easton factory and how we can control that quality coming out. And we're measuring those metrics, you know, outside diameter, weight, the quality of the carbon when we wrap it too as well.
Correct. Now there's more to it than just that as well. Yes. And part of that is the carbon fiber does not have the same consistency as aluminum alloy. Carbon fiber can vary by up to 2 million modulus, and that means that it can be a significant percentage of difference between one batch of carbon and another batch of carbon. Even if, as Easton does, you supply your carbon from the very best manufacturers in the world, and you hold them to tighter tolerances than they provide even to companies like Boeing. When we buy our carbon, we buy it from a very narrow window of what our suppliers can produce. And we test it before it goes into every batch of arrows. But even then, there's some variance because there's another element. You know, a significant percentage of the arrow is carbon, but there's also resin to maintain the structural integrity of those carbon fibers. The ratio of resin to carbon can also affect the stiffness of the arrow and the weight of the arrow. If you don't control your process, you might have more resin in one batch than another, and the one with more resin will actually generate a weaker spine arrow. That's what we call bulk modulus. It's the agglomeration of the carbon stiffness and the resin stiffness. The more resin, the lower the spine value. Even the interface between the carbon fiber and the resin has to be engineered correctly. That's done with something called sizing that's applied to the fiber. When we have total control of the process, we have total control of the outcome. Carbon is not a perfect material like aluminum is from the standpoint of engineering. So we take a lot of steps to overcome those shortcomings of carbon fiber. Carbon fiber, of course, has a tremendous number of positives going for it. It has a very high stiffness to weight ratio. For example, if we look at one of these X10 Parallel Pros, it's using a material that's over 47 million modulus. Aluminum is 12 million. So for a given mass weight of carbon fiber, you're getting a lot more stiffness than you would get from the equivalent mass weight of aluminum. Carbon fiber is only made in several moduli or stiffnesses that we can use for the purpose of an arrow shaft. Most carbon fiber that's made is made in a low modulus. It's made for bulk applications. Things like baseball bats or rowing equipment or the kinds of structures you might see on an F1 car, they're using a standard modulus material. We're using a high modulus material, a very high strength to weight ratio material that is much more expensive, but gives us the results that our consumers expect.
And what's the reason why archery has to use that higher modulus material than, say, another sport like golf, or like you're talking about baseball?
Well, golf does use some high modulus material, so do fly rods. Any structure that requires a very high performance from the standpoint of strength to weight is going to use the higher modulus materials. We do use the highest specification carbon fibers in the world for our premier arrows, like the X10, the X10 Parallel Pro, and the ACE. We use other modulus materials for toughness characteristics, like in the Easton Axis hunting arrow shaft. Those are selected for performance and a balance of strength, weight consistency, spine consistency, and toughness. As a general rule of thumb, the tougher the carbon fiber, the lower the stiffness tends to be. So there's a balancing act. Easton also takes another step that goes well beyond industry standards. We do what's called weight coating on our premier arrows. Arrows like the X10, the X10 Parallel Pro, and the ACE all receive a weight coat. Now, why do we have a weight coat? Because we cannot have both ideal spine and the same exact weight because of that minor variation in carbon fiber stiffness. Weight coating allows us to take all of the arrows, make them the exact same weight, and the exact same spine. If you take an Easton arrow and you put it on a spine tester, you will get the exact number that you're paying for. Now, Geoff, we've talked about the benefits of Easton's AC construction, leveraging the benefits of both carbon and aluminum to get you the ideal mixture of toughness and spine characteristics and high performance outdoors. Something we haven't talked about yet is our all carbon offerings, which we do under this roof right here at Easton Technical Products. The AccuCarbon process precisely locates each carbon fiber in a continuous process. It provides for perfect spine 360 degrees around the arrow. It also gives us total control over the straightness and the weight of the arrow, as well as the spine. The AccuCarbon process generates arrow shafts with no seams, so you don't have a hot spot, you don't have a high side for the spine value. You have the same spine 360 degrees around the arrow.
So from arrow number one to arrow number 10,000, they're gonna be exactly the same.
No one else in the industry is capable of making an arrow the way that Easton does with all carbon.
Another thing I'd like to add to that is that quality of control coming out with that AccuCarbon process, the component fit. You don't have to sand down anything. All of our components are gonna match right up.
There's another important characteristic that AccuCarbon gives you as well. Because it's a continuous process, there are no hooks or bends at the ends of the arrow. With a lot of wrap and roll carbon arrows, you actually have to cut off the ends to get a straight running broadhead or target point. You don't have to do that with Easton, whether it's the center of the arrow or the end of the arrow, it's the same straightness all the way across.
Yeah, tell me what the beginning of the arrow is and what the end of the arrow is. There's one beginning and there's one end.
Yeah, and you
can, and it's 10,000 arrows later, right?
If you didn't cut them off, you could end up with an arrow that's 7 miles long. You could do that. That is a characteristic that no one else in the industry has. And what Easton did was they took the shortcomings of carbon and built it as a strength. They took carbon fiber and optimized it, something that no one else in the industry is capable of doing at this time.
Thank you for joining us today. For more information on the entire Easton line, visit us at eastonarchery.com.